You know, I'm thinking Keith Cantrell is going to come on in a few minutes, so I'm not going to play very long. I'm sorry. Give me a minute. Lord, have mercy to get all this going. We need a team of multiple people, not just me. I hope you can hear me okay. I'm assuming that you can. I'm assuming this mic is not muted. I hope it's not. Somebody let me know if you can hear me. I'm not really sure why anybody would be interested in my age. I am an old man. I am 62. I will be 63 in a couple months. Well, 2.5 months or so. So now ask my birth date, and I'm not going to tell you. But I'll be 63 this year in 2024. So I was born in 61. Mom and I are 30 years apart. She was 30 years when I was born, and I think the math is right on that. She'll be 93 on the 10th of March. So Sunday, she'll be 93, and we are so excited because we get to spend Saturday morning with her enjoying her and all of her shenanigans. I have to tell y'all a joke, if I can tell you, that I heard this week. And to me, it was just so funny. And y'all, if these candles fall off, don't be surprised. I don't want them to drip wax on the piano, so I've got a linen cloth underneath it. So hopefully it wouldn't catch fire if the wax drops. But more than you wanted to know, we're just here in my living room, right? Okay, so this little kid walks in with his mom to a funeral. They sat on the back row in the church, and they sat beside a lady who had lost her arm. She only had one arm. And he said, you know, I was doing really great. It wasn't any problem until at the end of the funeral, the preacher asked that lady to come up and sing, "Precious Lord, take my hand." Y'all probably don't think that's funny. I personally think that's hilarious. Okay, so I'm going to try to. I am not going to sing as far as I know right now, but I'll try to play your request. Alan, for you and Jerry. Thank you.
Thank you.
So y'all may have seen my my friend Stephen Jones pop on here. I am very, very fortunate to call him friend. He is a local florist in Conway, which is the town next close, I guess, beside Myrtle Beach. And he did all the flowers. His florist did all the flowers for the camp meeting here in Myrtle Beach. And I was so thankful for that. But Stephen, when you came on, I thought, oh my Lord, you're going to see this concoction of hyacinths and Dutch iris and curly willow and something. I don't know what it is. I went to Fresh Market and tried to find something, and Danielle will do it for me or somebody else. I don't normally do it myself, but it's some flowers in a vase. And this vase is one of the vases that Paul Moore made for all of us to enjoy at camp meeting. And I'm so thankful for him. He just means so much to me. He's just, even though we haven't known each other a long time and don't know each other that well, he just is somebody who's touched my heart real deeply. Stephen, you ask for New York State of Mind. And I have played that for our friend Pam Hughes to sing. And I love to hear Pam sing it, but I will not play it all the way through because I don't know but the first little bit of it by heart, and it's been a long time since I played it. And that's it. But I'm taking the something on the Hudson River line. I'll learn it. I actually printed the music off, so I'll try to sit down and pick it out with the guitar chords. So let's get back to really why I played tonight. I don't know how I got off on the secular stuff, but I still think there's something sacred about it. We may be not singing to God himself, but we're certainly enjoying his creation. Stephen, I owe you one. And you owe me a time for dinner with me buying you dinner. So that being said, Stephen, it's not. Don't stretch the truth. I wish you could have run over and done it for me, but anyway. And Stephen plays beautiful piano. He plays for a local church, and I've tried to get him here to play, but for some reason we can't seem to make that work. So anyway, I saw this request come up. Thank you.
Thank you.
I know we're in the season of Lent, and I try to observe it and be follow the the protocol, because I think it's an important time for us, excuse me, not to be melancholy, but to be somber and to be reflective of everything that Jesus has done for us. But I did have a request for this, and I love to play this song. It's a fun song, and I'll probably play two that kind of same. That sound kind of alike, back to back.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so Keith Cantrell is going to come on. Keith, if you're, excuse me, if you're listening, Keith, would you come on and post in the comments your Facebook page link so everybody can just click on it? But Keith's going to, I think he's coming on. Don't hold me to it, but I think he's coming on at 9:30. It's Keith Cantrell, Cantrell Music. Yep, Keith Cantrell Music. Keith, post. Well, I don't know if you can type in your name or what, so everybody can just click on the link. But I'll just play. I'll play us out till 9:30, and then please go over and support Keith and enjoy hearing him. Thank you.
Thank you.